Welcome back. So every competitive exams are virtually a race against time. So time management is the most important factor in every competitive exams. Okay, questions are not tough, but time management is the most important factor. You are supposed to solve 200 questions in 2 hours. That is 120 minutes. So if you calculate, you will be getting only 36 seconds to solve one question. Using the conventional method of calculation, if you solve any question paper, you will not be able to solve not more than 100 questions in 2 hours. So we need to learn the speed method, the shortcut method of calculations. So today in this video, I'm going to tell you the 5 most important shortcut methods that are used by the toppers. The 5 most important shortcut methods. So let us see one by one what are the most important 5 shortcut methods which are used in mathematics to score good mark in every competitive exams. So here is your first method. So the first method what we are going to learn is the crisscross method of multiplication for 2-digit number. The crisscross method of multiplication by 2-digit number. When a 2-digit number is multiplied by any other 2-digit number, how fast we can calculate and find the answer in a single line. That is what we are going to learn in the first trick. So crisscross method of multiplication says, you need to multiply a 2-digit number. For example, you need to multiply 22. And you want to multiply it by another number. For example, let us take 32. What is the easy method of multiplying these two numbers? The shortcut method is, first multiply these two numbers. 2 into 2, 4. Then cross multiply and add. 2 into 2, 4. 3 into 2, 6. 4 plus 6, 10. Balance 1. And 2 into 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So in a single line, you can write the answer. The answer is 704. So what you need to remember, you have to remember the 3 steps. This is a 2-digit number multiplied by another 2-digit number. The first step, what we have done, we have multiplied these two numbers. So this is the first step. You have to multiply these two numbers and write the answer here. What is the second step we have done? A 2-digit number multiplied by another 2-digit number. We have cross and added. Cross multiply and add. Cross multiply and add. This is the second step what we have done. What is the third step? A 2-digit number multiplied by 2-digit number. You have to multiply these two numbers. These two numbers. So multiply these two numbers and write the answer. Every time write only one digit. If you have a 2-digit number, carry to the next place. One more example. For example, let us take a number 42 multiplied by 31, for example. So what's the first step? These two numbers. 2 into 1, 2. What's the second step? Cross and add. 4 plus 6, 10. Balance, 1. What's the last step? These two. 12 plus 1, 13. So we got the answer 1302. When 42 is multiplied by 31, we got 1302. So this method of multiplication is called crisscross method of multiplication. This is called crisscross method of multiplication. When you practice this method, I'm sure you will be able to solve any multiplication, any 2-digit multiplication within seconds. And that will definitely going to help you when you write your competitive exams. Okay, so in the next trick, what we are going to learn is how to square any 2-digit number. How to square any 2-digit number. So when I say 2-digit number, it starts from 10 up to 99. Any number from 10 to 99, if you want to find the square of any number, 10 square, 100, 11 square, 121, 12 square, 144. These numbers we know. But if I suddenly ask you what is 58 square, what is 98 square, what is 72 square, it is difficult. So if you want to square any number from 10 to 99, any 2-digit number, then we have a very easy method, and the shortcut method is this. Suppose we want to find the square of 24. So 24 square will be what? 2 square, write 04. Always write it as a 2-digit number. 2 square, 04. 4 square, 16. And 2 into 4, 8. 8 into 2, 16 in the middle. leaving one place from the right. So this will be 675. 576 is the square of 24. Let me explain it once again. What is 24 square? 2 square, 0, 4. 4 square, 16. Then the next step is 2 into 4 into 2. 2 into 4, 8. 8 into 2, 16. That 16 you have to write after leaving one place. So now add it. 6, 7, 5. 576 is the square of 24. Similarly, let us find out what is 26 square. 2 square, 0, 4. 6 square, 36. 2 into 6, 12. 12 into 2, 24. Write it first and add. Then you will get 676 is a square of 26. What is 32 square? 3 square, 9, and 2 square, 0, 4, 3 into 2, 6 into 2, 12. When you do it, you will get 1024. So fast you can find out the square of any two-digit number. Finding out the square of any two-digit number, this method will help you. So practice it, increase your speed. By practicing such questions, you are going to save a lot of time in your competitive exams. Again, let me remind you, competitive exams are virtually a race against time. Okay, so this method will be very useful for you when you prepare for your competitive exams. Now, let me go with one more example, a big number. Suppose you want to find out the square of 82. So, 82 square you want to find out. 8 square, 64. 2 square, 0, 4. 8 into 2, 16. 16 into 2, 32. Put it here and write 4, 2, 7, 6. 7, 6, 7, 2, 4. 6724 is a square of 82. This method you can use to find the square of any two-digit number. So let us go to the next trick. So trick number 3. We are going to see how to square any number ending with a 5. So squaring numbers ending with a 5. When I say squaring numbers ending with a 5, we have to start from 5, 5, 15, 25, 35, 45, 55. These are all the numbers ending with a 5. So let us write it first. So we have number 5, then we have 25, then we have, 15, then 25, 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85, like that it goes. So these are the numbers ending with the 5. So we all know 5 square is what? 5 square is 25. Even 15 square also easy, 225. 25 square is 625. And when I come to 35, we have problem. So now I will give you a trick using which you can find out the square of any number ending with a 5. You can see here 5 square is 25, 15 square last 2 digit 25, 25 square last 2 digit is 25. So any number which ending with a 5, any number last 5 means the square will have last 2 digit 25. So here we have 25, here also we will have 25, here also we will have 25. Here also we will have 25, here also we will have 25, here also we will have 25, it goes like that. Now we want the starting number. Here you can see 1. 1 multiplied by 2, you got 2. Similarly, 2 multiplied by next number 3, 2 into 3, you got 6. So multiply 3 by next number 4, 3 fours are 12. 4 multiplied by 5, 5 into 4, 20. Again, 5 multiplied by 6, 5 into 6, 30. 6 multiplied by 7, 6 into 7, 42. 7 multiplied by 8, 7 into 8, 56. 8 multiplied by 9, 8 9s are 72. So this way, you can find out the square of any number. The square of any number ending with a 5. The square of any number ending with a 5. Okay, so this is one of the very important trick. So let us go to trick number 4. So the next trick is base method of multiplication with a base number 100. When I say base method of multiplication, we have different base starting from 10. We have base 10, we have base 40, 50, 60, 100, 200, 300, 500, 1000, like that. So today I'm going to tell you base method of multiplication with the base number 100. So our base number is 100. When I say base number 100, we will be doing multiplication of numbers which are near to 100. So when we have numbers near to 100, we can take numbers from 90, 91, 92, 93 like that. And we can go up to 100, 101, 102, up to 110. So any number between 90 to 110, if you take, even if you can use this method for numbers less than 90 also, but for explanation, let me take numbers near to 100. Okay, so let me take two numbers. For example, I want to multiply 97 and 96. Or I want to multiply two numbers which are 103 and 104. These two numbers are less than 100. These two numbers are more than 100. So I want to multiply these two numbers. We know how to multiply these two numbers. Now we have learned crisscross method of multiplication using which you can multiply it. That is one method. The second method what I am going to tell you is the base method of multiplication. In the base method of multiplication, what we do, we have the base number 100. So what we write, we will see the deviation of these two numbers from 100. 97 is 3 less than 100. So we'll put a minus 3 here. And 96 is 4 less than 100. So we will put a minus 4 here. That's it. Now your answer is over. 3 into 4, put 12. 96 minus 3, cross subtraction. 96 minus 3, 93. Or 97 minus 4, this way also. 97 minus 4, 93. 9312 is the answer when you multiply 97 and 96. So simple and very fast calculation. These two numbers you need to multiply. So what we will do, 103 is a number 3 more than 100, so plus 3. And 104 is a number 4 more than 100, so plus 4. So multiply these two, 3 4s are 12, and cross addition. 104 plus 3, 107. So this way you can find out any multiplication of numbers which are near to our base number 100. So we have different bases like 1500. We have different methods also to do this. This method is for a base number 100. Okay, kindly note it and then we will go to the next trick. Okay, so in trick number 5, we are going to see a special division. That is base method of division by a special division by number 9. Any number, if you want to divide by 9, what is the easy method? So let us see, let us take a number like this. For example, this number I want to divide by 9. What's the easy method of dividing a number by 9? So here you can do like this. Just put this 3 here, put 3 here. And 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 2, 12. And wherever you have this 2-digit number, put it in the bracket. Now, the last bracket is 12, add 1 plus 2, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3, that 3 is the remainder. When any number is divided by any other number, we will get a quotient and a remainder. So here you got a remainder is equal to 3. Now we want quotient answer. So after putting 1 plus 2 equal to 3, take this 1 to this side. So this will become 11. Now put that 1 here and take this 1 to this side. This will become 7. And here 5 and 3. So 3, 5, 7, 1 will be the quotient. So what actually I am telling, when 3, 2, 1, 4, 2 is divided by 9, the answer will be 3, 5, 7, 1 and remainder will be 3. So let us go with one more example. You want to divide this number by 9. So now what is the method of division? We will put this 4 here. Then 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 0, again 5. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. 8 plus 3, 11. Whenever you have a 2-digit number comes, put it in bracket. Now the last bracket, add the numbers 1 plus 1, 2. So 2 is the remainder. So now take this 1 to this side, 8 will become 9. 9, 7, 5, 5, 4. This number will be the quotient. So any number when divided by 9, you can find out the quotient and remainder very fast. Very fast. And this method you can do using a separate trick which is called digit sum method also. Digit sum method, which we'll be explaining in the coming video. Okay, so 5 most important tricks we have learned. Practice it, increase your speed. I'm sure you are going to crack your competitive exams. So we will meet with a different trick and a different question paper in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.